Hello and welcome to the in-depth series section of Drishti IAS. I am Aisha Singh and in today's video we will be discussing about that China is on the brink of deflation. So what is deflation? And imagine a situation when the second biggest economy of the world is on the brink of deflation. So first of all, let us see the timeline. First, we'll be knowing about the news. Then what is deflation? What are its causes, effects, and what are the measures that can be taken to tackle deflation? Then what is deflationary spiral? And in the end, a prelims MCQ. This topic is of relevance from General Studies paper 3, that is economy. From exam perspective, you should be able to know from both prelims and mains causes, effect, and measures, because these can be asked in one form or the other. So the news says that China on the brink of deflation. What does this mean? So imagine China, who is known as a manufacturing hub, who is considered to be the second biggest economy in the world after the US, and is giving a very tough competition when it comes to the becoming the manufacturing hub of the globe, and then when it comes to making investments in some other countries. So that is on the brink of deflation. So what is deflation? You must have heard the term inflation. So I will be telling you in very simple terms. What is inflation? Increase of prices in normal day-to-day life is inflation. So what is at present happening is with tomato prices. So tomato prices at present in the market are very inflated. It is around 120 to 150 rupees per kg. So what is it? That is inflation. While on the other hand, if you talk about what is opposite of inflation, then the opposite of inflation is deflation. So when the prices are becoming low, or when the prices are declining, then it is called deflation. Like for example, I'll give you a very simple example, and that is, imagine this is June 2022 and at present what is going on is 2023. And imagine that we talk about the tomato prices. So in June 2022, the tomato prices were rupees 200. While in June 2023, the tomato prices are rupees 120. So what is it? That June 2022, the prices was 200, while June 2023, the price is 120. So what is it? It is deflation. And the rate with which the deflation is taking place is called disinflation. So in total there are three words that you need to be very careful, then only we will be moving forward with the term deflation. First is inflation, that is increase of prices or increase of goods and services prices. Then there is deflation, which is exact opposite of inflation, that is declining of prices, low prices, or the prices of goods and services becoming very low. And then the third, there is disinflation. So disinflation is the rate at which the prices are declining. Like for example, in June 2022 it was 200, then comes July it becomes 195, then becomes August, then it becomes 190, September 185, October 180. So the way or the rate at which the prices are declining is known as disinflation. So out of these three, we will be discussing today deflation, the opposite of inflation. So first of all, about the news. So the June has witnessed Beijing producer prices falling at their fastest pace in over 7 years. So over 7 years also include the period of the COVID-19. And this, when we talk about that the producer prices are falling in a country which is known to be the manufacturing hub of the world, which is known to be the second biggest economy in the world, which is known to be one of the top three economies in the world when we talk about the purchasing power parity. So overall, this is a concerning situation not only for China but also for the world. Then the consumer prices teetered to the edge of deflation, and the producer price index fell for a 9th consecutive month in June. So it means on daily basis and on continuous basis, decline can be seen. And it is down 5.4% from a year earlier, which is considered to be the steepest decline since December 2015. It means on regular basis, on continuous basis, on or consecutive basis, the decline can be seen. And the problem is that deflation might sound a good term, that okay, the prices of the goods are declining. It means the prices or the goods and services prices in China are declining. But this is not a positive term when we talk about overall economy of a nation, because deflation, if continued deflation takes place and if continued deflation happens, it might lead to a situation called slowdown, or it might reach to a situation called recession. If continuous and consecutive deflation takes place for a long period of time, and this is what is happening in China, and there are dangers that it could lead to slowdown or recession. Now let's talk about in detail the word deflation. What is it, its measures, causes, and how it will affect the economy. So first of all, in general term, if you will think that okay, in China the goods and services prices are declining, so it is good for the people of the China. But no, that is not the case. The people of China in a longer run will be at harmful place or will be at a harmful situation. So first of all, deflation is exact opposite of inflation. Inflation was increase in prices, deflation is decrease in prices. Then prices of assets and goods decrease across the economy. So it is decreasing across the economy. It is not that only in one sector it is decreasing. It is decreasing across overall economy, it is decreasing. Then reduction in its general price level. Like for example, earlier the tomatoes in China must be 120 rupees, but now it has come down to 80 rupees. The potatoes must be 200 rupees, now it has come down to 120 rupees. So like these, the normal goods and services prices have decreased. Then deflation also increases the value of money, because the purchasing power of an individual increases. Overall, the goods and services prices are decreasing. So what will happen? In a short period of time, the purchasing power of the people would increase. And that is why it would increase the value of money. And the example I've already given you, that if a product that cost rupees 200 last year is costing 150 now, so this decrease is called deflation. Then the nominal cost of capital, labor, goods and services fall as a result of deflation, because if the prices are reducing, then overall prices across the economies are also reducing, then the goods, services, labor, capital, or all these costs will also reduce, even if their relative price remain unchanged. Now, in a short period of time, deflation might look like, okay, this is good for the people. But if we talk about the longer run, then what will happen? It will lead to deflationary spiral that we will be coming and we will be discussing in the coming slides. So first of all, what are the causes? So in simple terms, if I say what is deflation? Deflation is when the price of goods and services are becoming cheap or are becoming economic or are declining. So what can be the causes of it? So first of all, the causes can be that you people do not have the capacity, or people like us do not have the capacity to buy much. It means the demand is less. We are not able to buy much. So there is no demand in the economy. So whatever commodities are present in the economy, they will be becoming, the prices of which will be coming or becoming low, because the demand is not there. So imagine if the supply is more but the demand is less. So people are not there in the market to buy it, but the supply is coming. That if there is more than enough material in the market that is present, and but the people who needs to buy those products are not there. So the more supply is more, demand is less, and higher propensity to save. So imagine there is a situation where people are not going and buying, they are not spending money. So what will happen if people are not spending money and they are focusing more on saving? Then how will the economy work? Because if the people would not go to market and buy things, then how the demand and supply curve would work and how the circular economy will move. So even if there is a situation which rises that people are focusing more on saving, then also the deflation can happen. Now let's talk about that, what can be the effects of deflation, that if in a country or if in an economy deflation comes and deflation rises, or the situation of deflation comes, then what can be the effects of it. So first of all, low growth, because if for a short period of time if deflation is coming for few days or few weeks, then it is fine. But for a longer period of time, if the prices are becoming low, then how will the growth of the economy happen? How will the people go and buy the things? Because if the growth will be low, then there would be many other repercussions also which would people be facing. Like for example, like you imagine the situation that if the deflation is happening and the prices in a country or in a economy have reached to all time low, then what will happen? The slowdown or recession would come. And if the recession would come, it means that there is no demand in the market, but there is supply, then what will happen? People will stop producing, then the production would stop because there is no demand in the economy. If the production would increase, if the production would stop, then what will happen? Then the people who are working in these industries and the production units, what will start to happen? Then layoffs will happen. Those people will have to leave their work. And if they have to leave their work, then what will happen? Then the salaries would become low. And if salaries would become low, then what will happen? Then the people will not have money in their pockets to spend. It means what will be impacted? The spending in the economy will also become low. Now, this is where the problem rises. If the economy in which we are living, the spending is low, then how will the economy work? If the spending is low, then the investments will be low. And if the investments will be low, the growth will be low. If the growth will be low, the GDP will be low. So automatically, everything would become a part of the circle, and the economy, overall economy of a nation would not be able to move at a good pace. So this is what the low growth aspect talks about. Then unemployment, as I've told you, would lead to layoffs, and layoffs would lead to unemployment. And if recession and slowdown would come, then job creation will not be there. Then recession, reduced wages and layoffs, as I've just told you, then reduces consumer spending. Everything depends on this point, that consumer spending has to be there. If consumer spending is not there, then the economy would not be able to move properly. Now let's talk about the measures, that what can be the measures to tackle deflation in an economy. First and foremost, the government should follow an easy or dovish monetary policy to make loans cheaper. So imagine a situation where the spending is not there and people in the economy are not able to spend things or are not able to buy things from the market. Then what will happen? It means there is no money in the market. Then what will the government of a country do? Or what will happen? Then the government needs to take the responsibility that it needs to make effort so that there is liquidity in the market. And for making liquidity in the market, what will they do? They will lower down the interest rates. Because if the interest rates will low down, people would come and take loans. And then they will also use a easy monetary policy so that the cheaper loans can be given and the interest rates would be low. Then tax deductions, because the people who pay tax, it means they are giving tax from their own pockets. So if the tax deduction would be lowered or the tax deduction would be cancelled, then people will have more money in their pocket to spend. Third, subsidy. The government will try to make things cheaper or would try to make things economic for the people to buy. Then encourage the purchase and expenditure. And that purchase can only be increased by either tax deduction, subsidy or liquidity inflow in the market. Then demand boost, expenditure on public projects, highways, dams, that the capital expenditure will create employment, and that employment will overall will be helpful in the job creation first of all, and then with job creation the salary would be given to people, and that is how they will have money in their own pocket, and then they will be ready to spend. So these are the measures that can be taken to tackle deflation. So deflationary spiral, even though I have told you also, but let's see this again. So first of all, what is the meaning of deflation? Lower prices for goods and services. From lower prices to goods and services, reduced profit and cash flow for firms, because if the prices will come down at a very low price at for a very long period of time, then this will also create problem. Reduction in production, because there will be no buyers, then what production would do? Increase in unemployment, if no production would take place or very less buying sentiment would be there in the market, then how will the production unit would sustain? Then they will lay off people. Reduced spending on goods and services, if people will not have money in their pocket, then they will not be able to spend it in the market. Oversupply of goods and services, because the supply would be more while the demand will be less, and this is where the uneven situation, more supply, less demand, the uneven situation would be created. So this will result to deflationary spiral, because a spiral would be created which will keep on moving. Now in the end of prelims MCQ, and you people need to tell me the answer in the comment section, and this says what is the best description of deflation. First, sudden fall in the value of rupee against other currencies. B, fall in the rate of inflation. C, persistent recession in the economy. And D is persistent fall in general price level of goods and services. You have to talk about best description. So there can be description which are right, but which one out of all four is best description? So try to solve the question and give me the answer in the comment section. And that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching. Till we meet next time, keep reading and keep writing.